Welcome to Breaking Down the Game. I'm Tyren Johnson, 10-year pro, currently playing in France. With Breaking Down the Game, I wanted to break down the game of basketball through film study and tips and drills that you can use to help improve your game. So sit back, pay attention, hope you learn something so you can go out there and make them pay. Let's get it.
What's up, everybody? Sorry for the delay. It's been a while since I posted a video, but I currently moved to Brussels, and it was a big move for me, and I had a lot going on, and it's hard for me to get places where I can record. I'm actually sitting in a closet right now, and I'm using this lapel mic to record this voice over right now. It's pretty interesting, but I want to talk about James Harden today. We're going to focus on him and break down his game. James Harden is a scorer. Pure score since he was young. I always loved this game. It's been very interesting to see how far he has taken his game. He has turned himself into one of the top three scorers in the league. This season he's averaging 34 points. Last season he averaged 36 points. I respect his game, but I do think his number is a little inflated. I'll get killed in the comments, but I'm cool with that. Just the style of basketball he plays, that should come with big numbers. For me, that style holds him back from being the best scorer in the league. If you look at his averages, he averages 12 to 11 free throws per game, making on an average of 10 free throws a game. If he scores 20, you can automatically say he has 30. A huge amount of points comes from his free throws. To his credit, they are fouling him, but I think he abused the rules. After you play against James Harden, you're gonna know you were in the game. His game is all about contact. Let's get into his game. James is pretty impressive on the inside. He likes to attack in secondary transition, where he gets a quick outlet and pushes it. He usually receives a middle pick or he attacks from the hash. He has a variety of Euro steps and a unique way of creating contact. One of his go-tos for creating contact is extending the ball through the defender's arm. It will automatically create a foul if the defender's arm is in his space. By the time the defender swings his arm back, he looks guilty and James gets the foul, and most times are and one. He likes to throw up floaters. His floaters is very efficient. He shoots it a lot off the wrong foot. As soon as he gets by his initial defender, he's searching for ways to create contact. Once he gets you on his hips, you're done. He's always pretty low on his drive, and it's hard to stop a player that's low and under control. While on the inside, Harden also has a variety of Euro steps. He changes speeds and directions pretty well for a player his size. Once again, once he gets you on his hips, you're done. Notice how he slows up, then get into his Euro step. Another thing he uses on the inside is a lot of long steps to create space. Now, when it comes to James scoring on the outside, this is where he really becomes amazing. The degree of difficulty on these shots are ridiculous. Contesting his shot doesn't matter. Only thing you can do is hope he misses. He creates a ton of contact from behind the three. We all know his go-to move is the step back. Let's get into it. Harden creates off the step back in many ways. He creates contact and then get into the step back. He has a tween dribble package, then the step back. He has a tween step back. He has the side step back too. He has another variation of the step back that many players don't use. he literally steps directly back and takes the shot. The move goes great with his game because he plays a rhythm game, and his rhythm off that shot is money. He really wants to lull you to sleep so that you drop your hands. He searches for contact so much, even do it from the outside from the three and end up getting 4-point plays. He literally grabs Murray's hands in this place. His tween step back is to just get you to take one step back. Once you react, his shot is up. He's giving you the illusion that he's about to drive and then bang. He uses the sidestep almost like Kareem used the hook shot. It's unguardable. He hits you with a dribble package to relax, and then he takes the sidestep for separation, and then boom. After that, it's just many different ways he hits you with the step back. I would do a separate video one day focusing just on his step back because it's really that good, and it really should be broken down from a mechanical point of view. I have information for days on the way he utilizes this move. The most lethal part of James' game is his strength. Watch how he creates contact to take advantage of the D. Hesitation is a staple in this game. He has that wiggle. Last video I said Luka don't really have that wiggle. Well, James have that wiggle. You have to respect it because he has so much options off it. He can step back, he can drive, or he can set up a teammate. James doesn't really shoot many mid-range shots. It's pretty simple for him in this area. He penetrates and he usually go with a snatch back dribble. Normally when he's in the post, he's looking to get into your chest and get into a step back. James is a triple-double machine. His size and strength gives him many advantages. He has a variety of passes in his package. When he's playing, he showcases his playmaking skills with fancy passes. He has the same float I described with Luka. His float is so similar to when he's shooting, you don't notice when he's actually throwing an alley-oop. Players like Capella makes James Harden almost unstoppable. He attracts so much attention, he can pick defenses apart. A lot of the times, he's just reading the defense to pick them apart. When it comes to athleticism, James is also sneaky. I said Luka has sneaky hops, and some comments thought that was a bit racist. Well, it's the same situation here. James is black, and I think he's sneaky athletic. He doesn't wow you with many dunks, but when he drives, anything is possible. He can hit you with a floater, a tough layup, or he can dunk on you. James' athleticism to me shines in his strength. The guy's a rock. His core has to be super strong. I love the way he plays with the low center of gravity. I live in Houston, so I see James quite often, and he has a real big lower section. I don't want to say he has a real big butt, but he has a real, that area seems very strong and well put together, and guys like that are normally super athletic and they have a lot of control. So I can see how he just beats up many guards whenever he play. James is one of the best ball handlers in the game. He keeps the ball on the string. Like I said before, he's always pretty low when he's dribbling. He loves to do a tween series to read your feet. The whole time he's dribbling, he's seeing how you react. Then he reacts. He usually go with tween combos with a tween cross to finish. He tends to stand straight up sometimes. Whenever he stands straight up, you should be expecting an attack to come. This make it tough to predict what Harden's going to do next. Normally he's low, and then he goes to standing straight up. It makes you think as a defender what's finna happen. It makes the defender start lifting and dropping, lifting and dropping. And once a defender is lifting and dropping, the offense got you. James doesn't get much lift on the shot like most scorers I've been studying lately. He has no wasted motion on his jumper. Soon as he sees the rim, that shot is going up. He shoots some trailing threes. He may come off a stagger every now and then, but most of his jumper come off his own creation. I see a lot of guys trying to stay on his left hand and contest his jump shot. It doesn't matter, because soon as he sees the rim, it's over. That's how lethal of a scorer he is. He's one of the best scorers of all time. So you can do whatever you want to do. It ain't gonna work. James take big shots and he make big shots. The guy's a shot taker and he's a shot maker. Although I still don't think he have that one shot where you can just look back and say that was the James Harden shot, like the Kawhi Leonard shot or the Michael Jordan shot. But I'm still waiting for that one shot that's very important that can be a staple in his career. But James definitely has that clutch gene. He's made a lot of big shots and he's made a lot of comebacks. Like he did against Golden State Warriors. He brought the Rockets back from nothing and made it happen. What can make James Harden unstoppable? I've been looking at everything. The truth is, James already pretty unstoppable. When a guy put up numbers like him, you can't really say he needs to improve on something. He's averaging 36 and 34 points per game. And his team is winning. They haven't won a big one, but his team is, you know, they compete. So I don't really know what can make James Harden unstoppable. If you guys know, leave it in the comments to help me out. Now, what I do know, or what I do think I know, my opinion, stopping James is pretty tough. The only person that can really stop James is James. I would definitely put a player on him full court, make it very uncomfortable for him. Too many times he brings the ball up with no pressure. Sending him left or right would not work. He's too talented. I would send a designated helper at him all the time. Who's ever guarding the weakest link, I'm sending that guy. The guy that's guarding James Harden should make him drive. Let him drive right into the help. The best you can do. If the other guy is going to beat us, I'll live with that. But what I'm not doing is letting James Harden control the tempo and control the game. I'm going to send bodies at him time after time after time after time. I'm going to face guard him. I'm going to bump him. I'm going to make it so uncomfortable for him to where he's super tired. Because that's all you can pretty much do, because he can score from the outside. He can score from the inside. And his jumper is pretty much unstoppable. So that's all I got for James Harden. Please like, share, comment. If you guys, you know, disagree, leave it in the comments. If you guys got some other thoughts or some things I missed out on, leave it in the comments. You know, I want to build this community where everybody has some type of input. And I love learning, so I would really appreciate it. Besides that, if you guys want to do some training, you can go to my website, TyrenJohnson.com/training. I got two programs up there. It's called the Make 'em Pay Scoring System, Make 'em Pay Ball Handling. I got the Truth Life Podcast, where I'm giving advice on how to live a truth life. It's a mental approach and confidence builder podcast. Besides that, man, just thank you guys for the support. Keep watching. Please subscribe so that you can know when it's coming. Hit that notification bell. And until next video, thanks, man. Appreciate it.